It's arguably the most mysterious place in the world, where great hunks of ships have plunged into the abyss, where pilots and their planes have vanished into thin air. Batten down the hatches and join us on our journey into the deltoid of death. Number 50. Before we regale you with stories of tragedy and downright dumbfoundedness, for our viewers not exactly educated on the basics of the Bermuda Triangle, here's some practical information. It's an area in the North Atlantic Ocean that has one point touching Miami in the US, going all the way down to Puerto Rico and up to Bermuda. Nonetheless, the exact area is not defined. All you need to know is it's in that vicinity. Since it's not exactly exact, the area is said to be anything from 500,000 to 1,510,000 square miles. That's a lot of space. Somewhere between the size of South Africa and a bigger India. It's a lot of room to get lost in, and as you'll now see, that has happened time and time again. Number 49. A man named E.V.W. Jones wrote an article in the Miami Herald in 1950 titled "Seas Puzzles Still Baffle Men in Pushbutton Age." It was one of the stories that inspired the mystery of the Bermuda Triangle. While the article didn't mention a triangle per se, the rather poetic piece did talk about ships and planes just disappearing, and we mean completely disappearing. The article described one such ship called the Sandra. This 350-foot freighter with 12 men on board was taking 300 tons of insecticide from the US to Venezuela. It didn't get there. Searches were made in vain. Not even a remnant of the ship or its crew was found. It was written down as an official mystery. Number 48. At 4 a.m. on December 27, 1948, a plane carrying 32 people, including two babies, radioed control. It said it had almost completed its journey from San Juan, Puerto Rico to Miami. It was just 50 miles from its destination. Nothing untoward was reported. The plane was fine. The weather was okay. So why did that plane and all those people never get to Miami? How come after extensive searches, nothing was ever found? It wasn't just a one-off. Just a year later, another plane went missing. This is what was written about that disappearance. Aircraft carriers, cruisers, destroyers combed the water with thousands of pairs of sharp eyes on watch. They found no hint of the plane's fate. As you'll now see, many stranger things have happened. Number 47. It was a guy named George Sand that really cemented the mystery with an article he wrote back then. In this story, he talked about the 1945 disappearance of Flight 19. This is one messed up tale if there ever was one. On December 5th of that year, five Grumman TBM Avengers set off on a training exercise from the Naval Air Station Fort Lauderdale in Florida. Not one of those five planes or their 14 occupants was ever seen again. The flight leader, Charles Carroll Taylor, had 2,500 hours of flying experience. The other pilots might have been trainees, but they at least had something like 300 hours of flight time under their belts. The training operation should have had three legs, with the first being bombing practice. The base and other planes heard through the radio that this had been completed since one pilot said he dropped the last bomb. Part two of the exercise, it seems, didn't go so well. Sometime during the second part of the exercise, something went wrong. Rains and winds came as well as thick clouds. One of the trainee pilots radioed in and said, "I don't know where we are. We must have gotten lost after that last turn." Taylor also said at one point, "Both my compasses are out. I'm trying to find Fort Lauderdale, Florida. I'm over land, but it's broken. I'm sure I'm in the Keys, but I don't know how far down, and I don't know how to get to Fort Lauderdale." The last message that came wasn't good news. He said, "All planes close up tight. We'll have to ditch unless landfall. When the first plane drops below 10 gallons, we'll all go down together." After that, a haunting static buzz could be heard. That was it. Gone. Everyone was just gone. Flying boats went to the areas where they might have gone down. One of them was manned by 13 crew. It too vanished. Nothing of the planes or the flying boats was ever found. A Navy lieutenant said about that, "We had hundreds of planes out looking, and we searched over land and water for days, and nobody ever found the bodies or any debris." Okay, so what had happened? What went down in the sky to make those pilots so disoriented? Again, no one knew. It was listed as an unknown cause. This inspired countless theories back then, just as it does today. People have talked about aliens taking out the planes, which in this current era of alien fascination would perhaps not sound so inconceivable. Others talked about parallel dimensions where the pilots had been taken. Number 46. Actually, in 1991, a bunch of treasure hunters shocked the world when they'd announced they'd solved the mystery of Flight 19. They'd found remnants of World War II Avenger planes off the coast of Florida. People thought that the Lost Patrol mystery was over, but no, the serial numbers didn't match up, and so to this day, no one knows what happened to those planes. Number 45. From 1942 to 1945, 95 pilots out of NAS Fort Lauderdale lost their lives. But what's so strange is that people and planes often remained missing after extensive searches. Okay, so some hard facts now. Number 44. Did you know that no official map exists that actually has the Bermuda Triangle on it? In fact, the US Board on Geographic Names doesn't even acknowledge it exists. Number 43. Even though a few people have talked about this deadly area for some time, it wasn't until 1964 that the Bermuda Triangle really got its name. That was after a guy named Vincent Gaddis wrote a story about the mystery in a pulp magazine. Number 42. Maybe you believe people snatching aliens are to be blamed for the vanishings, or you might think pilots headed off to a parallel world. If that sounds outlandish, some writers have tried to convince us that the lost city of Atlantis is behind it all. One 1974 book that posits this is The Bermuda Triangle by Charles Berlitz. Just to show you how much people love reading about the mystery, that book sold 20 million copies in 30 different languages. Number 41. The area is one of the busiest places in the entire world regarding shipping lanes. Number 40. The Bermuda Triangle is home to the deepest part of the Atlantic Ocean, the Milwaukee Depth, and at the point called the Puerto Rico Trench, it has a depth of 27,493 feet. Still, that's not quite as deep as the Challenger Deep in the Pacific Ocean that's 36,200 feet deep. Number 39. It's not known exactly just how many ships and planes have gone down over this area, although a rough estimate would be 50 ships and 20 planes. In terms of planes, that number is likely low. Most of the time, none of the wreckage is ever found, and oftentimes there's no explanation as to why the accidents happened. As you'll see later, what's really disturbing is there have been disappearances that involved large vessels carrying many, many people. Number 38. There have of course been practical theories as to why things vanish out of sight. It's not a theory, but a fact that over this area the weather can change so fast you would hardly even see it coming. That's one reason why so many people might not send a distress call. It's the naval or aviation equivalent of being sucker punched. Number 37. There's another less obvious thing that can happen over this wide area. Researchers have found that deep below, decomposing sea organisms create methane gas. When lots of it accumulates, it forms methane ice, and when that breaks up, gas shoots up through the ocean. No vessel would ever know it's coming. So there's another sucker punch for you. But what's really interesting is scientists say this eruption of gas would make the water less dense, and a ship could go down. Since the water is so deep, that ship could disappear as quickly as Fun did in 2020. Let's stick with the practical, but with a guy that actually experienced a weather phenomenon himself while flying over the triangle. Number 36. His name was Bruce Gernon, and on December 4th, 1970, at the age of just 23, he was flying in his small plane when things got really weird. He and his pop had taken off from Andros Island in the Bahamas with the intention of getting to Palm Beach, Florida. Both men were pilots with lots of flying time, especially the father, who was the pilot that day. They'd been informed that the weather was clement, and while flying everything was fine. Except at some point during the flight, they said they seemed to enter what they described as a strange tunnel that was in the middle of a cloud. For about 10 seconds, they said the aircraft became weightless, but even stranger, all the instruments in the plane started to go crazy. There was no blue sky to be seen, just some peculiar gray, and that seemed to go on for about 2 miles. Panicked now, they radioed to Miami and said things had taken a turn for the worse and they were inside some really sketchy weather. Miami responded saying, "Nope, we can see nothing on our screens." Later, the controller said he spotted their aircraft not far from Miami Beach, to which the guy said, "That's not possible, we haven't been flying long enough." But it was correct, and they soon saw the beach. They were way ahead of schedule and had saved 10 gallons of fuel. So, what happened? Well, it's not exactly science-based, but Gernon believes that the tunnel they were in was some kind of electric fog, and something had happened in there that had propelled their plane faster. Obviously, they couldn't read the speed because the instruments weren't working. Gernon has since appeared in more than 50 television documentaries talking about this theory. This is an excerpt from one of the books written about him. Bruce Gernon is the only person to have witnessed its birth stage through the mature stage to the heart of the time storm, escaping through a tunnel vortex, and resulting in a time warp of 30 minutes forward in time and 100 miles forward in space. Okay, so some of you are calling cow dung on this one, but keep watching, things will get freakier. Number 35. There have also been a bunch of UFO sightings over this particular area. Number 34. One of them was in 1978, when a Greek merchant marine radio operator named Polycarp Spetsnaz had the fright of his life. These are his own words. "We started from Puerto Matanzas, Cuba, bound for Algiers, with an average speed of 11 miles. Shortly before 12 noon local time, the officers of the ship's bridge began to notice that it appeared to them that the ship was sailing at unusually high speed. But the instrument showed a constant speed of 10 to 11 nautical miles per hour. He said the ship went through the water as it had never done before. He and the crew had no idea what was going on. Then things got weird when a guy came up from the engine room and said all the clocks for some reason had gone forward 2 hours. A bit later, Spetsnaz's mind pretty much went to pieces. This is what he said happened. The cook and I were playing backgammon in the smoking room when suddenly we looked back and saw to the left of the ship, i.e. the northwest side, just a few miles away, a large, white, unidentified flying object in the sky. He said two smaller objects were next to it. He didn't immediately want to think aliens, so tried to calm himself down by telling him it was the Americans doing some kind of secret aircraft operation. Still, why were the clocks wrong? and he couldn't really explain the movement of the things in the sky since no aircraft could do that. In interviews that followed, he said all the crew experienced a slower heartbeat at the time, as well as bradycardia and hypothermia. He believed that it was down to something he called gravitational time dilation. He said this caused biochemical changes in the crew's bodies. It sounds crazy, but this guy doesn't look like he's joking. Number 33. Still, for most people, they don't get treated to a strange phenomenon like that. One sailor who's been through the triangle more times than he can count said, "I've raced through the Bermuda Triangle. Never has anything strange happened." Number 32. The triangle gets the blame for many things it likely wasn't involved in, including the disappearance of the Malaysian Airlines Flight MH370, even though it went missing on the other side of the globe. Number 31. It didn't help matters when a politician from Malaysia tweeted a few years back, "New Bermuda Triangle detected in Vietnam waters. Well-equipped, sophisticated devices are of no use." Part of the theory that goes is there's another triangle like itself directly opposite. Maybe there's a wormhole thing going on. Number 30. As to why ships go down so fast, there's another theory that posits it could be something called rogue waves. These can reach 100 feet high. We actually prefer the name monster waves or killer waves. Basically, certain weather patterns can occur all at the same time and great big waves can occur. Something big enough to sink a very sturdy ship. They are scary too, as you'll now see. Number 29. It took some time for science to actually record a rogue wave, but when it did, there certainly was another thing to fear for sailors. When the master of the RMS Queen Elizabeth II was hit by one in 1995, you could say he got a shock. His exact words were, "It came out of the darkness, and it looked like the white cliffs of Dover." It had to kind of surf the almost 100-foot wave to avoid sinking. Number 28. There are also liars when it comes to the Bermuda Triangle. That writer we mentioned earlier named Charles Berlitz wrote about ships and planes that went missing that actually never existed. This next one counts, though. Number 27. In 1969, two lighthouse keepers were busy at their jobs on the Greater Isaac Lighthouse in the Bahamas. Okay, so there was bad weather, but the guys one day just went missing and were never found. Number 26. In 1963, the SS Marine Sulphur Queen went missing, and all 39 people on board were never seen again. Although in this case, there were ample reports stating that the vessel was not fit to sail. Still, the families of the sailors wanted to know where their loved ones had gone missing, and a huge investigation ensued. But like many ships and many men, all the searches came up with nothing. This next one is very sad indeed. Number 25. It's the story of two 14-year-old boys who went fishing off the coast of Florida. They never returned home, and a search of 15,000 square nautical miles found nothing. One of the guys prior to their disappearance wrote a message on Instagram to another friend. It read, "Me and Austin are crossing to the Bahamas tomorrow. Come with us." Later, via Snapchat, one of them wrote, "Peace out, Jeff." That was said to be their last message, although a friend of the guys said they posted a video with a huge dark storm moving toward their boat. The words next to the video were, "We're..." The next word is a well-known expletive. The boat was recovered about 1 year later, about 100 miles from Bermuda. There was no sign of them, although an iPhone was found. People said there might have been foul play since the ignition and battery were turned to the off position, although storm damage is the most likely scenario. Unfortunately, Apple couldn't open the phone. Let's now go way, way back. Number 24. In the year 1800, the topsail schooner USS Pickering met its match in the Bermuda Triangle. It left from the US on its way to the West Indies, and somewhere in between just vanished, along with 90 crew. Nothing of it was ever seen again. It's believed a storm was to blame, but that's only a hunch. You can put that one in the mystery folder. Number 23. The same thing happened the very same year, and also in the West Indies, to the USS Insurgent. It just vanished without a trace, as did its 70-something crew. People have put two and two together, saying maybe one particularly nasty storm wrecked both ships. Other than that, the crews of those ships could be right now laying back in Atlantis or hanging out on the planet Okeanon. In both cases, you don't age. Okay, now let's talk about ghosts. Number 22. Has a ghost ship ever been found in the Triangle? The answer is yes, although we can't find much information about it. The ship was called the Rosalie, and it was found empty in 1840 somewhere in the area. She was bound for Havana, and the crew vanished somewhere along the way. We found one article that said when she was found, her sails were set, everything shipshape. The only living thing aboard was a half-starved caged canary. Number 21. Then there's the story of the ship Ellen Austin. The legend had it that she left Liverpool in the UK to head to New York in December 1880. She sailed for many weeks, and at some point, the captain thought it'd be a good idea to sail through the Sargasso Sea. That's located in the Bermuda Triangle. On the way, they found a schooner and no crew on it. Okay, spooky, but the captain wasn't scared and told his men to sail it back to the US. There was a huge storm, but after it cleared, the captain got close to the schooner and he called to his crew. No answer. Where'd they gone? U.S. newspapers had started writing about the story, with one asking why she was derelict no man could say, since she was apparently in good condition. The thing is, it was later discovered that Lloyd's of London had recorded the journey and no missing people were talked about. Many people think the story is a case of the game of telephone and myth, although some people think it happened. Number 20. This is definitely real. In 1880, the British ship the HMS Atlanta set sail from Bermuda back to the UK. It went missing somewhere on the way. This was no small deal. 281 people were on that ship and they vanished. A long investigation and search ensued. Nothing came up. One sailor, who'd not gone on the journey but should have, said he feared the ship wasn't in the best shape and there wasn't much experience on board. In fact, the Times of London wrote, "There can be no question of the criminal folly of sending some 300 lads who had never been to sea before in a training ship without a sufficient number of trained and experienced seamen to take charge of her in exceptional circumstances." This next one is also exceptional. Number 19. In 1492, when Christopher Columbus and his crew were on the Santa Maria and approaching the Bahamas, they saw something they couldn't explain. It was a strange light, like nothing they'd seen before. Number 18. Staying with the past, the American warship called the USS Wasp met its end in the Bermuda Triangle. This had been a strong ship and it had been very useful when fighting the British. She took down three British ships, in fact. She may have been good at trouncing Limeys, but she was no match for the wretched Bermuda Triangle. On October 9, 1814, she was heading to the Caribbean and she vanished. No one knows what happened, but 140-odd men that were lost did. Okay, but what about these days, like really recent goings-on? Number 17. In 2017, a private jet was in the area and it suddenly went off radar. It remained a mystery until a few days later when the wreckage was found. All four crew had perished. What was to blame? This was noted as the cause. The pilot's intentional flight into an area of known icing and convective thunderstorm activity, which resulted in a loss of control of the airplane. It was thought he hadn't got enough sleep and made a mistake as a result. Number 16. On April 10, 2007, another small aircraft, this time carrying two people, went missing over the Bahamas. In this case, it said the pilot hadn't asked for a weather briefing. He should have known thunderstorms were forecasted and it wasn't a good time to fly. Aviation data tells us there was no request by the pilot to air traffic control for weather avoidance assistance or weather deviation. Radar and radio communications were lost and the wreckage and occupants were not recovered. Number 15. You probably didn't know that some people think William Shakespeare's play The Tempest was based on the wickedness and the wonders of this treacherous part of the Atlantic. It's said in the early 1600s, stories got back to England about ships being wrecked close to Bermuda, and this may have inspired the scribe. There was a publication at the time in something called the Repertory about the shipwreck of a ship named the Sea Venture, which was bashed up near Bermuda on its way to Jamestown. The content, some scholars have said, bears similarities to Shakespeare's play. He very likely read this about the real-life shipwreck. "The seas did rage, the winds did blow, distressed were they then. Their ship did leak, her tacklings broke, in danger were her men. But heaven was pilot in this storm, and to an island near." We bet you didn't know about this next one either. Number 14. A guy named Joshua Slocum was some sailor. In fact, he was the first person ever to sail around the world by himself. This intrepid man set off from the US to the West Indies in 1909. He said bye to his wife, kissed her on the cheek, and set sail. No one ever saw him again. Fun fact, he couldn't even swim and said there was no point in learning. Number 13. Since we've come to the unlucky 13, we thought we'd give you something spooky. We could have mentioned it earlier, but it's more fitting now. Remember Flight 19 and all those missing men? Well, just before they lost communications with the base, one of them said, "Everything looks strange." Number 12. We also didn't tell you this. You already know the US Navy never figured out what happened to Flight 19, but in one report someone wrote, it was as if they had flown to Mars. Now you'll see how the Brits were equally stumped when they lost quite a few of their countrymen around the same time. Number 11. The BBC said back in the 1940s, when passenger jets were really taking off, pun intended, they were impressive things indeed. They were also fraught with danger. Take, for instance, the British South American Airways. In 3 years running, it reported 11 accidents, 5 planes lost, 22 crew dead, 73 passengers also dead. Would you have taken a trip with them? In 1948, a small British passenger plane just vanished over the Bermuda Triangle. No one had any idea what happened. 25 passengers and 6 crew were gone. The final report read, "It may truly be said that no more baffling problem has ever been presented. What happened in this case will never be known, and the fate of Star Tiger must remain an unsolved mystery." Still, these days, when we look at how dodgy those planes were, it's easy to come to the conclusion that any matter of fault could have taken them out of the sky, especially when in bad weather central. Number 10. Let's stay with the Brits. Almost exactly a year after that passenger flight went down, another one took off. This time was traveling from Bermuda to Jamaica. 1 hour later, the pilot radioed in and said everything was fine. He had enough fuel, the weather was good, the plane was tip-top. That was the last thing ever heard from the pilot. 20 people died, and not one single bit of that plane was ever found. A report stated some external cause may have overwhelmed both man and machine. It was statements like these that helped kick off decades of wild speculation. Okay, we think you need some good news now. This will put a smile on your face. Number 9. In 1949, a US B-29 vanished. It was thought all 20 men had died, but then a Canadian destroyer was flying over the Bermuda Triangle and spotted something. There were 18 men floating in two rafts in the ocean. They'd been on the move for 3 days and had traveled some 75 miles. The New York Times wrote that all the men were in serious condition and had to be taken to a hospital with haste. At first, the survivors were so weak they weren't well enough to explain what happened. We only know that somewhere on the journey from California to the UK, things went wrong. The paper called it one of the biggest search operations in peacetime. Number 8. The SS Cotopaxi was believed to be a victim of the Bermuda Triangle for many years. In 1925, she set sail with 32 people on board and vanished without a trace. We had to wait until 2020 to hear that parts of the wreck found earlier were her. Okay, now we're approaching the big guns. Number 7. This is a New York Times opening paragraph from October 18, 1976. A 590-foot cargo ship with a crew of 37 has been missing since early Friday and is feared sunk in the area known as the Bermuda Triangle, the Coast Guard reported yesterday. This was quite an original case because sometime after it disappeared, an Argentine freighter found one of its lifeboats. Only 1 hour after that, a British ship found a burnt life preserver in the water. A spokesperson for the search party said it's not easy to miss a 590-foot-long ship on a day with visibility of more than 40 miles in calm seas, so it doesn't seem too hopeful that it's still afloat. It wasn't, and it was never seen again. What's strange is the ship had not sent a distress message before it vanished. Number 6. Did you know there's another triangle in the world that's said to be cursed by paranormal activity? It's called the Dragon's Triangle, and it's located in the Pacific Ocean. So many ships have gone missing there that the Japanese have declared the area a danger zone. Now for another terrifying ghost story. Number 5. Let us introduce a schooner named Carol A. Deering. On July 19, 1920, it set off from Puerto Rico with its captain and hero of World War I, William H. Merritt. He got sick and was replaced by Captain Willis B. Wormel. They got to Rio, unloaded their cargo, and had copious amounts of booze. They set off again on January 31st, and the ship was spotted hard aground next to some shoals with the sails set. This meant trouble. It took some time because of harsh weather conditions, but rescue boats eventually got to the ship a few days later. Guess what? There wasn't one person on that ship. It was quite a bit smashed up on board, and the navigation equipment was gone along with the ship's log. The lifeboats and all the crew's belongings were also gone. The ship was in such bad condition that it was agreed that it should be blown up. But what happened to the crew? Well, a fisherman in 1921 found a message in a bottle. The message read, "Deering captured by oil-burning boat, something like Chaser. Taking off everything, handcuffing crew. Crew hiding all over ship, no chance to make escape. Finder, please notify headquarters Deering." The writing matched that of the engineer, and the bottle had been made in Brazil. It looked right, but then that fisherman admitted he'd forged the note in an attempt to look good and get a job at Cape Hatteras Light Station. We just don't know what happened. Freak weather might have caused the trouble, but seriously, would all the crew have died in those lifeboats? Possibly, but researchers have said the ship wasn't heading into any storms. Others have blamed pirates or maybe smuggled the ship wasn't heading into any. But then there's the Bermuda Triangle theory. This story is a conspiracy theorist's golden goose. Number 4. Okay, now for some healthy skepticism before we talk about the very worst thing that ever happened in the Bermuda Triangle. Do you remember we talked about the pilot Charles Taylor, the one who led trainee pilots in Flight 19 operation and none of them was seen again? Well, that pilot, as experienced as he was, had actually been lost 2 times before and both times had to be rescued. The Navy did indeed report the tragedy was cause unknown, although some skeptics say that it was because of pressure from his mother, who said if you can't prove it was his fault, then you can't say that, even though it's said that fateful night he took the guys in the wrong direction. Number 3. Other skeptics have pointed out a simple fact. Number 3. Other disasters take place in the Bermuda Triangle, as they do in other parts of the world's ocean. But the thing that inspires mystery is the lack of distress calls and the fact that things just vanish, whether planes or ships. As we told you, though, the water is insanely deep and the weather is about as predictable as the number of views we get on videos. Then there are those darned methane events down in the ocean. Okay, last bit of skepticism. Number 2. We track flights over this area using a live tracker. You can see that passenger planes fly over the Bermuda Triangle all the time. Right now, as we write this, the flight map of that place looks as busy as supermarkets last year when people thought they were going to run out of toilet paper. Okay, now for what we've all been waiting for. Number 1. On March 4, 1918, the US suffered what is still the biggest loss of life in Navy history, not including during combat. This was the sinking of the USS Cyclops. While some people don't think it sank and would prefer an alien abduction theory, that day 306 men lost their lives. They and the entirety of the ship just vanished. The cause of disaster is still listed as unknown. On February 20th, it set off from Salvador with the intention of heading back to the US. Something terrible happened on the way, and despite umpteen investigations, no one knows what happened. The Navy held up its hands and admitted, many theories have been advanced, but none that satisfactorily accounts for her disappearance. The theories obviously include one huge storm, but then it was said the ship was overloaded, or maybe there were just problems with the engine. But get this, just as the search was coming to an end, the US State Department received a letter signed by Charles Ludlow Livingston, the US consul in Barbados. Part of it went like this. Master, alluded to by others as damned Dutchman, apparently disliked by other officers. Rumored disturbances en route hither. Men confined and one executed. Also had some prisoners from the fleet in Brazilian waters. One life sentence. The letter seemed to suggest there had been some kind of mutiny on the ship. It turned out it was actually written by the consul's cheeky 13-year-old son.